For all those of you who are interested in visiting Italy for its culture, beauty, and history, St. Mark's Square is one spot that you wouldn't want to miss out on. Located in Venice, St. Mark's Square is also known as the Piazza San Marco by the locals. Although it might not seem important for you that a square could be crucial to the city, this one definitely is. There are also tons of other exciting places around the piazza, which we'll be telling you all about later on. History of St. Mark's Square. To start off with this place, we would first like to tell you a little bit about the history that lies in this square. Initially, back in the old days, this square was considered to be a normal square, unlike all others. It had several trees that were lined around the square and tons of open space for people to mill around and relax. The only reason why this piazza or this square was notable among the locals was that right in front of it, the St. Mark's Basilica was constructed. However, with time, the importance of this square soon escalated. When once it was just a square for people to relax, now it has been turned into the biggest and most important square in the city of Venice. Back in the old days, and when we say old, we mean really, really old, like back in 1267, this square was enlarged and the area of the square was completely paved with bricks, giving it the cobbled look. From there on, the place was used as a gathering spot for Venetians and as they would come and gather here. By then, the popularity of the square had heightened quite a bit and famous architect Andrea Tiralli was brought in to design it. Andrea worked his magic and removed the bricks to place natural stones instead. He also did it with an organized approach. St. Mark's Basilica. The St. Mark's Basilica is a church that is placed right in the center of St. Mark's Square. Known for housing the body of St. Mark himself, the basilica was canonized by the famous Doge Domenico Contarini. This was done by him in the 11th century. This is because some merchants stole the body of St. Mark and brought it to Venice with them, and hence the church was constructed for him. Internally, the church is even more gorgeous, with mosaics all over the 40,000 square feet space. Externally, it has been designed in the exact shape of a cross of Greek times, with a dome on the arms and the central crossing point. This church is open for the public to visit, however, make sure that you on the opening hour specified. Doge's Palace. Next up, we have for you the famous Doge's Palace. When we talk about the culture of Venice, this palace plays an important role, being one of the most famous spots in the whole world. This is also the most famous building in all of Venice. For years and years, the purpose of Doge's Palace was to act as the seat of government, as the Doge residence, and as the place of justice. Here, the most important decisions were taken for Europe, including Venice. While it may look like the epitome of the epitome Venetian Goth architecture today, back in the old days, it looked like a basic castle that was built with high defensive walls. While it is true that the architecture of the castle is quite intense, the best thing about it is that it still gives off a vibe of lightness, which is the main feature of the architecture of Venetians. National Archaeological Museum of Venice. Maybe you would like to head to Italy and see some museums for yourself, to take in the history and the culture. If yes, then you definitely would not want to miss out on the National Archaeological Museum of Venice. Situated very near the famous St. Mark's Square, this museum is bound to leave you stunned for all that it has stored in itself. The National Archaeological Museum of Venice is known to be home to tons of crucial sculptures and other collections that have been saved for centuries and centuries. There are even some very important and original sculptures of the Greeks here as well. Another reason why this museum is said to be so crucial is that it houses tons of different gems, bronzes, coins, and ceramics as well. To elaborate a bit more on this, you will even find the ancient Assyrian Babylonian items and Egyptian pieces stored in this museum. Now, Who would want to miss out on this? Today, if you visit this museum, you will have tons to do. There is the Korer Museum right next to it, and the Piazza has a lot of cafes and restaurants for you to visit as well. For all those out there who would like to get a glimpse of the history of the city and of the ancient times, this is the place to be at. And there you have it, folks. That's it for today. Those were some of the most important places around St. Mark's Square. Moreover, we also give you a glimpse into the history of this famous square. Make sure to add it to your bucket list, comment down below, and let us know what you like the best.